to
rise and follow me. I'll make you worthy. Rise and follow me. I'll make you fishers of men. Rise and follow me. I'll make you worthy. Rise and follow me. I'll make you fishers of men. Cast your nets aside and join the battle tide. He will be your guide to make you fishers of men. Rise and follow me. I'll make you worthy. Rise and follow me. I'll make you fishers of men. Rise and follow me. I'll make you worthy. Rise and follow me. I'll make you fishers of men. Jesus bore the cross to gather in the lost. Oh, what a mighty cost to set us free from sin. Rise and follow me. I'll make you worthy. Rise and follow me. I'll make you fishers of men. Rise and follow me. I'll make you worthy. I'll make you fishers of
we gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us take a moment to call to mind our sins.
I confess
to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most gracious fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, who gave us the Paschal mystery in the covenant you established for reconciling the human race, so dispose our minds, we pray, that what we celebrate by professing the faith we may express in deeds. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. After the crippled man had been cured, while Peter and John were still speaking to the people, the priests, the captain of the temple guard, and the Sadducees confronted them, disturbed that they were teaching the people and proclaiming in Jesus the resurrection of the dead. They laid hands on Peter and John and put them in custody until the next day, since it was already evening. But many of those who heard the word came to believe, and the number of men grew to about 5,000. On the next day, their leaders, elders, and scribes were assembled in Jerusalem, with Annas the high priest, Caiaphas, John, Alexander, and all who were of the high priest class. They brought them into their presence and questioned them, "By what power or by what name have you done this?" Then Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, answered them, leaders of the people and elders, if we are being examined today about a good deed done to a cripple, namely, by what means he was saved, then all of you and all of the people of Israel should know that it was in the name of Jesus Christ, the Nazarene, whom you crucified, whom God raised from the dead, in his name, this man stands before you healed. He is the stone rejected by you, the builders, which has become the cornerstone. There is no salvation through anyone else, nor is there any other name under heaven given to the human race by which we are to be saved. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. The stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone.
The stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. Let the house of Israel say, his mercy endures forever. Let those who fear the Lord say, his mercy endures forever.
The stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone.
The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done. It is wonderful in our eyes. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice in it.
The stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone.
O Lord, grant salvation. O Lord, grant prosperity. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. We bless you from the house of the Lord. The Lord is God, and he has given us light. The stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone. Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice in it.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus revealed himself again to his disciples at the Sea of Tiberias. He revealed himself in this way. Together were Simon Peter, Thomas called Didymus, Nathanael from Cana in Galilee, Zebedee's sons, and two others of his disciples. Simon Peter said to them, "I am going fishing." They said to him, "We also will come with you." So they went out and got into the boat, but that night they caught nothing. When it was already dawn, Jesus was standing on the shore, but the disciples did not realize that it was Jesus. Jesus said to them, "Children, have you caught anything to eat?" They answered him, "No." So he said to them, "Cast the net over the right side of the boat, and you will find something." So they cast it and were not able to pull it in because of the number of fish. So the disciple whom Jesus loved said to Peter, "It is the Lord." When Simon Peter heard that it was the Lord, he tucked in his garment, for he was lightly clad, and he jumped into the sea. The other disciples came in the boat, for they were not far from shore, only about 100 yards. Dragging the net with fish. When they climbed out on the shore, they saw a charcoal fire with some fish in it and bread. Jesus said to them, "Bring some of the fish you just caught." So Simon Peter went over and dragged the net ashore, full of 153 large fish. Even though there were so many, the net was not torn. Jesus said to them, "Come, have breakfast." And none of the disciples dared to ask him, "Who are you?" because they realized it was the Lord. Jesus came over and took the bread and gave it to them, and in like manner the fish.
This was now the third time Jesus was revealed to his disciples after being raised from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
How impatient and slow to learn are we? Jesus would say to his disciples in another part of the gospel, I am the vine, you are the branches, and apart from me, you can do nothing. So the disciples come back after a night of fishing and have caught nothing. And so Jesus instructs them. And they said to him, no, we already did that. Didn't work. You did it your way. Now let me go with you and do it my way. And what happens? An abundance of fish, more than they can count. As we journey through this Easter season, this COVID-19 season, how impatient have we become getting back to normal, wanting to rush back into the way we did it before? Maybe it's time just to slow down a little bit, which we've already done, but reassess. What is most important as we go forward? What are the things that we truly miss? Do we want to get back to just the busyness for being busy's sake? Or do we want to do things that matter and that count, that make a difference? The apostles went out on their own, wasted a whole night. Jesus simply gave them an instruction of what to do. In a very short period of time, they caught more fish than they could count. We do things our way, we come up empty-handed. We do things God's way with God's grace and God's blessing, and the fruits are abundant. Let us now gather our prayer.
That the whole church in this Easter season feel the enthusiasm of the first Christians in spreading the good news. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all Christian women and men witness the resurrected Christ in all they say and do. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who gather here and in their homes to celebrate the Lord's rising from the dead, and who share his body and blood and share in spiritual communion, recognize Jesus in one another. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all our healthcare workers, first responders, all the sick and suffering, especially at this time of the COVID-19. That all may be safe, all may be healed, all may have strength and peace in their lives. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our St. Matthew's families for whom this Mass is being offered, as well as for the souls of our faithful departed. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father Mercy, we thank you for the resurrection of your Son. Receive our prayers and concerns, which we offer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread, the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Pray, my friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Perfect within us, O Lord, we pray, the Solomon's chains brought about by these paschal offerings, that we may be drawn from earthly desires to a longing for the things of heaven. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, the universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Holy,
holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When
we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, George, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and I unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Father Mercy, Divine Architect, you call us to build up your kingdom. We, the parish family of St. Matthew's, humbly ask your blessing on the spiritual, human, and financial commitment we have made for a pathway to our church. Unless you build a house, we labor in vain to build it. Bless us with generous hearts, open minds, greater unity, and renewed vision. Through the intercession of Mary, Mother of God, St. Joseph the Builder, St. Matthew our Patron, and St. Michael the Archangel, bring to perfection the good work you have begun in us. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us pray. Hear, O Lord, our prayers, that this most holy exchange by which you have redeemed us may bring your help in this present life and ensure for us eternal gladness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia.
St. Michael,
the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.